Felicidades a todos ellos y ellas que han contribuido para hacer y llegar al 30 aniversario. El consulado reconoce su esfuerzo, reconoce el corazón de conservar las tradiciones en un país y en un ambiente multicultural donde la importancia de tener este tipo de recintos y de actividades. Le quiero entregar un pequeño presente de parte del consulado para Calmeca en reconocimiento a sus 30 años y desearles que los siguientes 30 sean mejores. Gracias.
Muchas gracias. About 7-8 months ago, Calmeca was invited to participate in a board with the police service in Calgary. Constable Gary Woods, he is the head of the Latin American and Caribbean Division, as I told you before, and he invited me to be part of this talk. So Calmeca has been participating actively with the police service, and tonight Gary Woods has a message and would like also to say something to you. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm actually a little nervous. I've done this I don't know how many times in presentations, but never to a group of people like this. So bear with me and hold your applause until the end. Consul, Mr. Villar, Mr. Solozano, President of Calmeca Maria, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor and privilege for me to stand here tonight before you as you celebrate, well, two things, your 202nd anniversary of independence. I think it's tomorrow, and also 30 years of Calmeca society in Calgary. So congratulations to all of you on both. It's a very hard job keeping all those things together. Independence maybe not so much, probably harder to keep the society going. The Calgary Police Service, I guess it's something that most of you only call whenever you're in trouble. Nobody will. And even then, maybe some people have difficulty calling us. We see ourselves very much as an arm of the community, not as part of the government or the state, whether it's provincial or federal. Calgary Police Service is your police service. We see community policing, and policing is everybody's responsibility. It's not just the responsibility of the police, it's the responsibility of the community as well. And that's all the various communities in Calgary. Building strong relationships and strong communities, and relationships such as we have with Calmeca, that to me is central to building strong communities, building safer communities, which is what we all want for ourselves and for our children. And again, you know, with those strong relationships, it helps us to understand what it is that you want. It's not what the police want to do with you. We need to know what you want in your community. And by talking to each other and communicating, that's how we find out what it is that you need and what you want and how we can best deliver that to you. So that's the purpose of what I do. A little bit, I'm in the diversity resources team, which is a team of 9 police officers. It's the largest and oldest team of its kind in North America. We have a geographical portfolio covering everybody in the world, Africa, South Asia, Caribbean, Latin America, Aboriginal people, people with disabilities. Wherever you come from in the world, or whatever your orientation, there is a police officer in Calgary for you. And my purpose is, as a liaison, that you can come to for advice, for information. It's difficult, as I said at the beginning, for some people to come forward and speak to the police. But maybe if you know one person like me, you know, you can talk to me. I can talk to Maria and she can talk to me. That way it's easier. So I have all these notes, but I'm not even going to use them. So I'll kind of read that. So basically my job, I guess, is to promote open and positive dialogue with your community and to change some of the expectations which you may have. Because I know that outside of Canada and even where I came from in Ireland, some people have very negative experiences with the police. For different reasons. So you come here with that expectation. My job is to show you how the Calgary Police Service does business, and that we're here as your friends and here to help you, which is important. Yeah, so just in closing, whatever it is you want, I need to hear from you. I want to learn from you. I want to learn about what you need. I want to learn about what your community needs. So come and talk to me tonight and right over here. Or after tonight, talk to Maria, and one way or another, we'll open the lines of communication and keep doing what we're doing to make Calgary a safer place for everybody. Enjoy your evening, and congratulations. Thank you.
Gracias, Gary. Esta noche también tenemos al señor Carlos Solórzano. Es el consejero consultativo del Instituto Mexicano de Mexicanos en el Exterior. Él fue nombrado hace casi un año y también quiere dirigirse a ustedes esta noche.
Muchas gracias, María Luisa. Muchas gracias a todos. Muchas gracias a Calmeca. Es un honor estar aquí con ustedes, poderles platicar un poco del Instituto de los Mexicanos en el Exterior y el papel que yo voy a estar representando por los siguientes 3 años como consejero del Instituto de los Mexicanos en el Exterior. El honor es más resaltable cuando estamos celebrando los 30 años de Calmeca. Los felicito. Este es el primer año que se nombra o se abre la oportunidad para un consejero del Instituto de los Mexicanos en el Exterior para las provincias de Alberta y Saskatchewan. A finales del año pasado se llevó un proceso de elección del consejero y me vi favorecido con ese honor. Es una función voluntaria, no gubernamental, que estaré llevando a cabo en los siguientes 3 años. El propósito de este consejo consultivo para el Instituto de los Mexicanos en el Exterior es tener representantes de las comunidades mexicanas en las distintas jurisdicciones en las que tiene presencia y ser un vehículo de comunicación hacia las autoridades mexicanas de las necesidades y de las inquietudes que tiene la comunidad mexicana en esas distintas jurisdicciones. En ese sentido, me convierto yo en un receptor de todas las inquietudes, quejas y necesidades que tengan ustedes y que necesiten encontrar el receptor y el posible solucionador de esas quejas o necesidades. Estoy basado aquí en Calgary, exactamente enfrente de aquí del Danish Club, es mi oficina. Y como les digo, esto es un cargo honorario, voluntario. Entonces yo tengo mi propia oficina aquí, pero ahí mismo en esa oficina, cruzando la calle, estaré listo para atender cualquier necesidad, cualquier inquietud que ustedes puedan tener como su representante, como representante de la comunidad mexicana en Alberta y Saskatchewan. Tengo unos folletos que traje conmigo, unos trípticos que quisiera entregarles durante la noche para que tengan mi contacto, mi teléfono, mi correo electrónico y se puedan dirigir. Para mí va a ser un honor durante estos 3 años poderlo representar y les agradezco su atención y estoy aquí a sus órdenes. Gracias.
Bueno, por último, como ya dijimos, tenemos a Dolores Dill, quien fuera la primera presidenta de Calmeca, y ella nos va a dirigir unas palabras sobre su experiencia de aquellos tiempos.
Buenas noches.